was born in Gainesville, and as many a Texas boy will, he thought that hunting was a lot of fun. But instead of going out with a squirrel rifle, Frank said, for all my life I'll do my own kind of hunting without a gun. That's why in Singapore and Saskatchewan and Borneo and the Amazon, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back alive. In Minnesota and Mandalay, in the Philippines and Philadelphia, PA, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back alive. Now once he was attacked by a spitting cobra, as if that ain't enough to make you sober. His only way of escape was past an angry orangutan. So he tied that snake into a lariat and lassoed the monkey where he sat. As he let them out, the people sang again. In Rancho Fort and Rhode Island and Texarkana and in Thailand, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back to life. In Egypt and in Illinois, in Paris and in Perth and boys, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back to life. Back in 1953, when Frank Buck's biggest adventure began, he was called before the throne of heaven as soon as he arrived. Buck took a new job that day in glory to add one last chapter to his life story. He's trying to trap the devil. He's gonna bring him back alive in New Orleans and Nova Scotia, Kilimanjaro and Kenosha. Everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back alive. In Hawaii and in Hong Kong too, California and Kalamazoo, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back alive. In Padre Island and Panmunjom, Pensacola and the Pentagon, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring him back alive. In Cincinnati and Cicero, Terlingua and in Tuckahoe, everybody knew the name of Frank Buck, the man who'd bring 'em back alive.